Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Indie Horror Spotlight. I have a zit on my forehead. Try not to pay any attention to that. I guarantee you will. Anyway, I've been gone for a little while. I lost my save file for the Crooked Man, so I still have to go back through and play through that to catch myself back up. And I kind of got caught up playing Valorant and Elden Ring in a bout of sleep. Took me a while to pull myself back together. Tonight, I decided I wanted to show some love to the Copper Cube community. There's a horror game that's been passing around, making some fairly substantial waves here and there, that comes from a member of the community. This is the first time in series history I've paid money for a game. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Smiling Man. I donated $10 because this game seems like it has a ton of effort put in, and knowing what I know about Copper Cube Engine, everything I know about the community, all of the progress everyone has made over this last little bit of time, I'm really excited to see how this goes. I don't know anything about it. By the way, I played a release version way back for a couple of minutes, and it was good, but I don't know anything else. We're here. That certainly is a smiling man. This is really neat. Especially since I know how this was done. And I don't just mean like I know what engine it was made in. I know the inner workings of the engine. I know what it's capable of. This is going to be a very interesting experience for me. And I already love it. I already love it. That music is sick. I'm not sure if it's copyrighted. I have a habit of leaving everything for the night. Yeah, many say that this hobby of mine is strange. And then I decided to go shopping in the market for dinner at dawn. But tonight, I came face to face with evil. It was a horrible and scary experience. It was 2 a.m. Never call the smiling man at 3 a.m., guys. All right, this is actually really gorgeous. That filter is sick. I don't know how that was done, but I really dig it. I could just be like a texture. He watches you all the time, even at bedtime. All the time. Okay. So this is just like Friendly Neighborhood Walk, the video game. I like it. It's gorgeous. It looks really good. Don't let their expressions fool you. Their feelings and wants are different. Hey, bud. Yeah. What? Alright, you have a good time. Let's keep going. This place is, like, really well made. I know what the world spaces in Copper Cube look like, and, like, this is a substantial amount of world space for the engine to render at once. Get to the market. There's nothing here, it's just a road. Phone booth. The little things make this really interesting. Like the small graphic design details, decisions that were made here. Look, you can see the edge of the texture around the car was real well. Oh, I love it. This is, in fact, the market, but it looks closed. Huh. Whoa. So, dude. Oh, listen to that. I don't know many markets that just play smooth jazz at 3 in the morning. But hey.
It was $1.81.
Okay. Oh. Oh, shit. I was just having a good time making memes at the text-to-speech, and then that creepy fucko pops up out of nowhere. Oh, and there he be. He's a Slender Man. Wait, it took way quicker to get here than it took to leave, it feels like. It feels like I walked a shorter distance back than I did forward. That could just be my brain playing tricks on me, it likely is. God. You can't just catch a guy off guard like that, guy. Jeezums. The next night, I've already been thoroughly fucking pants pissed. What do you want from me? Still the same? Yeah, it's still the same. Hey guy, you're everywhere. You're starting to really bug the hell out of me too. Like, it was kind of meme-y at first, but now I'm like genuinely mortified. Wait, what did I skip? What happened? I'm concerned. I don't like that I skipped something that could have been important to me, that very well could have meant the death of me! Guy, what the fuck? Ah! Okay. So, I have a couple of things to say. I am already on edge. Freaky shit's been happening around here lately. I'm a skeptic. I don't believe in shit, really, but, like, freaky shit's been happening around here lately, so I'm already on edge looking over my shoulder behind me and shit. It does not help that I decided to play a game so jump scare heavy, and that the jump scares were done in such a way that they were genuinely terrifying. Like, I was tense and waiting for the next jump scare. It wasn't just like I was, oh, this is jump scares, cheap terror, you used a moment to get to me. No, I anticipated this coming. And still, even when it came, I was piss terrified because it's just really creepy. The atmosphere here is unbelievable. You did such an amazing job. Noxus Studios, you did such an amazing job on this. I cannot believe it. That this came out of Copper Cube, that it's so well made. This may be one of the best indie horror games I've played in a long time. With all of that said, sorry I disappeared. Sorry about the zit that's taking your attention away from my voice. Thank you, and have a nice day.